And now we're finally back. As promised, I have here a professional to answer your questions regarding hair loss. So we now have Dr. Rica Mallari. She's the head of hair unit, Dermatology Center of St. Luke's. She's also a fellow of Philippine Dermatological Society. So, hi, Doc!
Hi!
So, Doc, she is Steph.
Hello!
Hi, Steph.
She has many questions regarding hair fall. But before that, I want to ask Doc,
actually, marami ha, from yung young ones and yung kids to old people, all males and females, pareho meron hair loss talaga. Yan yung pinaka problem nila. But there are lots of causes of hair loss. Pero in women, yung na-encounter ko, meron yung shedding, so nagka-fall, hair fall talaga. Yung iba, may bald patch, yung bald patches na present. Yung iba naman, titim lang, parang wala naman shedding, pero nagtitim. But the most common cause of hair thinning and shedding is yung pattern hair loss na tinatawag. Yan yung ano eh, genetic thinning.
Okay.
Yan yung gradual na parang minipis yung hair, little by little, hanggang nauubos siya. The other one, yung alopecia areata, yung sinasabi ko na patches.
Okay.
Pwede totally mawala yung hair eh. As in, pati eyebrows, mawala, body hair. So, concerned din yun, kailangan i-address as early as possible. Tapos yung isa naman, yung shedding.
Okay.
Yun, marami rin causes. Pwedeng crash diet, pwedeng nanganak, yung mga ganyan. Yun yung usual causes na gano'n yun. Fever, hair shedding, yun yung nagpapot. Actually, during pregnancy, yun na yung ano yun, parang mag-hair growth sobra. It's after giving birth that the hair usually falls. So, medyo kakaiba na konti yung nangyari sa kanya. But usually, siguro mga 3 months after giving birth or 4 months, yun na, nagka-shell na hair. Dami, makatapat everywhere.
Yes.
Kahit saan ka nandun, sa pillow mo, pag-ising mo nandun, sa bathroom, sa habang nagpa-brush ka ng teeth, nandun sa sink.
Yes.
So everywhere you go, parang, ano ba ito, baka maubos yung hair ko. Yun yung nakatapat. It's called telogen effluvium. Yun yung term for that case.
So, in layman's term, ano yun?
Hindi ko alam kung anong tawag dun sa Tagalog.
Basta na-telogen lang.
Oo, parang temporary shedding. Huh. And it happens because of, ano, yan, isa is after mag-deliver, yan yung common cause eh. Pwede fever. Yung high fever, yung mga nag-dengue, mga ganyan. Viral example na kasama yun. High fever, pwedeng crash diet. Uso din ngayon yun, yung nag-diet ng sobra. Tapos, within 3 months, they lost mga 60 pounds. Yun, pwede mag-shed din. Or, pwede rin yung mga hormonal problems like thyroid problem, super high or super low, pwede mag-cause ng shedding. What else? Kulang sa zinc, kulang sa protein. Yung mga common causes na ano. To take supplements, yun yung pinakamaganda. Pero kung hindi naman, kasi common din naman na nag-hair shedding, pero wala naman yung deficiency.
Mm-hmm.
So, pwede mag-apply lang ng mga solutions, yung mga parang natural solutions that will nourish the root of the hair.
Okay.
Kasi kung minsan ano lang siya eh, yun yung because of temporary shedding. Pwede rin yung shedding because of mga procedures na nagawa, pero if it's yun, iba naman yun, hair structure, yung strand mismo ang mapuputol.
Mm-hmm.
Yun yung mga sa rebonding and everything. But if it's just because of yung, yung giving birth or during pregnancy, temporary lang yun. Yes, it will be just a phase. So, gradually, mawawala din. Pero syempre, gusto rin sa akin, nourish yung root. So, it's good to apply also yung
products
na that will nourish the roots. Yung age ha, actually lahat pwede, yung from the young ones to the old ones. Yung kung sa young ones, yung mga maliliit na bata, pwedeng alopecia areata, like sinasabi ko dito na mention na may patches. But for the thinning of the hair, after puberty, pwede na mag-start.
Mm-hmm. So as early as
13
years old?
Wow! Patient 13 years old, ano minipis na yung hair eh.
What's the age of your youngest patient na may hair issue?
13.
13?
And you know, pwede yung medicine, like, since it's a genetic thing, tuloy-tuloy lang yun. The root will become smaller and smaller for every hair cycle. Yan yung ano naman. But this is the genetic thing.
Okay.
Not the temporary shedding that we were talking about. Mm-hmm. Yung sa nananak. as early as possible mas maganda.
To prevent?
Yeah, sometimes kasi hindi mo alam eh. Hindi mo naman napapansin. Like the gradual thinning that I was talking about. It's a genetic thing. Minsan hindi mo naman napapansin kasi nandito siya eh.
Yeah.
Actually, yung sa genetic, ano, it's 40% of males who have it eh, by the age of 40. Kaya lang, lahat sila, mataas yung ganun, genetic thinning and the hair shedding, the hair shedding. Common yun, very common. Pareho silang common.
Even the sa side effect ng pregnancy, no, yung falling
pag... Oo, pag-fall ng hair dyan and the stress. Yes, pag stressed out ka, what happens is, when you're stressed out, muscles nag-tense. So pag tense, yung blood vessels nag-constrict. So yung blood supply to your hair follicles, parang nagkukulang yung mga distribution ng follicles.
So kapag stressed ka yung blood flow mo na
kulang.
Ah, okay.
Yung pumapasok na sa follicle, hindi siya na nourish yung mabuti. So ang tendency, magpapol din yung hair. Iba nga naglalagay pag yung strain. Kasi pati yung pigment forming cells, hindi sila nakaka-ano, nakaka-produce ng pigment. So nag-white yung hair.
Siya ngayon.
Ah, so baka may alopecia areata, dahil yung brown patch?
Yeah, pero parang wala na. Wala na. Wala na.
Diba ngayon baka ano?
Tagal
na. Pero ito yan usually the thinning, you know, is your hair. They have the part in the middle para makita. Usually ito yung process part. And if you're starting yun nga, when your family is to do thinning, I mean, you're starting to use hair, better to apply na. To apply yung anti-aging for hair.
Ayun! Thank you so much, Doc. Thank you, Steph, for your time. So, guys, wrap up muna natin to. If you have any more questions, just comment on the video. Ask more questions. Who knows, may part 2 tayo with Doc Rica. So, again, thank you so much for watching us. And thank you for your time.